Hello, you guys, and welcome to Designer How. Today, we're going to discuss spinning transitions done with a little twist. Let's get into it. On the timeline, we have the two clips for which we want to make the transition. A rotating transition is nothing new, but today we'll add a little added flavor to ours. First, head to the project panel and click the icon for new item. Select adjustment layer and drag it onto the timeline. Shorten the layer and place it above the intersection where your clips connect. Go into Effect, type Replicate, and drag the Replicate effect onto the Adjustment layer. Now go back into Effect and do the same thing for Mirror, only this time, repeat the process until you have a total of 4 mirror effects up on your layer. In Effect Controls, under Replicate, we will set count to 3. Already you can see the footage being divided on the preview monitor. Head back into Effect Controls and under the first mirror for Reflection Center, set the X axis to about 1277. Under the second mirror for Reflection Center, we set the Y axis to about 719, and we set reflection angle to 90 degrees. The X axis of the third mirror we'll put at 640, and we'll bump up the reflection angle to 180. For the fourth and last mirror, we'll set the Y axis to 360 with the reflection angle at negative 90 degrees. Create a new adjustment layer and place this atop the one already on the timeline. Adjust its size to match the other one. Go to Effects, type Transform, and drag the Transform effect onto the top layer. Back to Effects, and we'll type Directional, then drag on the Directional Blur effect as well. In Effect Controls under Transform, create a keyframe for rotation at the first frame, and the keyframe will automatically be set to its default values. Now we'll skip a few frames ahead with the right arrow button and create another keyframe. This one we'll put at 5. Now scrub the timeline to the intersection where the clips connect. That should be the center of both your adjustment layers. Here, we'll create a keyframe for 180. We'll rearrange the second keyframe a bit and then move to the last frame of the layer. This one we'll set to 360. Scrub a few frames back, create a keyframe for 355, and we are done for the day with rotation. As you can see, though, our footage spins, but there is a lot of black dead space interfering with our beautiful, beautiful transition. Worry not, we'll fix that by heading to Scale under Transform and creating a keyframe for scale. Next, we'll match the timeline to the second keyframe for rotation and create another keyframe by setting scale to 250. After that, we'll match up with the second to last keyframe for rotation and create a keyframe in scale again for 250. On the very last frame, we'll put the value back to 0. Very good. To finish off, we'll go to Directional Blur and Effect Controls and create a keyframe for blur length. The first frame will be set to 0. Now again, match up to the second keyframe for rotation, create a keyframe for 20. The same goes for the second to last one. Match up to rotation and click the Add Keyframe button to create a keyframe with the same value of 20. Then on the final frame, put it back at 0. I think it looks good, but the transition happens a little too fast for it to really shine. This isn't a problem. Don't panic just yet. We'll just lengthen both adjustment layers and reposition them so that their centers are again positioned above the intersection. Then all we have to do is drag out the keyframes so that they are centered again. While we're at it, let's set all the first keyframes to ease out and the last keyframes to ease in to make the motion more dynamic. And just like that, we have us a beautiful take on the rotation transition. That's it, guys. Please like and subscribe for more tutorials like this, and we will see you all on the next one.